A very good morning to all of you. I hope you are well. So in the previous video, we have started with the topic flower of chapter number 5, that is the morphology of flowering plants. So today again, I'm here to introduce you with some of the new terms that are related to the word inflorescence. So let's start with the first term. First is bracteate and ebracteate plant. So before starting with this, I would like to tell you what is the meaning of bracket. Actually, bracket is a modified leaf-like structure which is present near the flower. You may see in this diagram. Here you may see a leaf-like structure is present at the base of flower. This leaf-like structure is known as bracket. So if a flower consists of a bracket, that flower is known as bracteate flower. If a flower lacks this leaf-like structure, it is known as ebracteate flower. Next term is complete and incomplete flower. As you know, a flower consists of main four parts, that is calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx is a group of sepals. Corolla is a group of petals. Androecium is the male reproductive part, and where is gynoecium is a female reproductive flower. So if a flower consists of all these four main parts, then a flower is said to be a complete flower. Example you may take is China rose, that is the shoe flower. And in case if a flower lacks any one of the four main parts, then that flower is known as incomplete flower. Example is onion and lily. Next term is bisexual, unisexual and neuter flower. We have done the discussion over the bisexual and unisexual. Bisexual flowers are those flowers which consist of both male and female reproductive part. That is the presence of both androecium and gynoecium. In case of unisexual flower, it will consist either of androecium or gynoecium. That means presence of any one of the reproductive organ. In that case, that flower is known to be a unisexual flower. And the last category is neuter flower. It is that flower which lacks both androecium and gynoecium. Next term is monoecious and dioecious. Mono means one plant. Dioecious means two plants. So in case of monoecious plants, a single plant will bear both androecium and gynoecium. So a plant with presence of both androecium and gynoecium is said to be a monoecious plant. Example you may take is cucumber. Next is dioecious plants. That is the requirement of two plants, because one plant will consist of androecium, whereas second plant will consist of gynoecium. So in case of dioecious plant, there is requirement of two plants. One will bear male flowers and second will bear female flowers. Example you may take is papaya. Next is isomerous flowers. Isomerous flowers are those flowers in which each whorl, that is calyx and corolla, each whorl has an equal number of parts or its multiples. For example, there are two sepals and two petals. That flower is known to be isomerous. If a flower consists of four sepals, four petals, means four, again that flower is known to be a isomerous flower. Example you may take is bimerous. Bi means presence of two whorls or its multiple. If a plant consists of, or a flower consists of, two sepals, two petals or multiple of two, that is four sepals or four petals, that flower is known to be a bimerous flower. Example is mustard, because it consists of four whorls. Next is trimerous. If it consists of either three whorls or multiple of 3. Example you may take is flower lily or daffodils. Again, tetramerus or pentamerus. If there is a presence of 4 or more than 4, or presence of 5 or more than 5 parts, then a flower is known to be a tetramerus or pentamerus. Next is calyx. That is the group of sepals. So what is the main function of calyx? It provides a role of protection. It is generally green in color and it is the outermost whorl of a flower. If the sepals are free, that means they are not fused with each other, we are going to use a term that is polysepalous. Sepalous means presence of sepal. Poly means free. That means all the sepals that are present in a flower, they are free. They are not fused with each other. Example you may take is again mustard. Second is gamosepalous. Gamo means if all the sepals are fused with each other, they are known to be the gamosepalous. Example you may take is petunia. Next is corolla. It is again group of petals. What is the main function of corolla? They are meant for the attraction. So they play a major role in pollination, because by attracting insects, insects would transfer the pollen of one flower to the stigma of another flower. So if petals are free, then they are known as polypetalous. Example is again rose. If the petals are fused with each other, they are known as gamopetalous. Example of polypetalous is rose, and example of gamopetalous is bindweed. This is a white color flower. I hope you are cleared with the terms. So in the next topic, I would like to start with the presence of ovary and the positions of ovary. Thank you so much.